alignment.
We're ready to start our scoot adventure. I feel like yeah, I already did mine. Or you could just scan that. All right. Well, these might be malfunctioning today. I don't know what's going on. Try it again. Is this a camera? Or what is it? A light?
Nighttime
riding. Oh, okay. Alright, we're gonna try to figure this shit out. If not, we're just gonna hop in the Kia. What's happening? What's happening?
There's nothing. It's taking so long to go.
Okay. YouTube. Y'all about to get my ass fucked up. You talking about TikTok? Sorta. Oh, Lord. Yeah, so Skips ain't working. We're going to hop in the whip and ride the fuck out. Loser. Well, do you wanna never forget me and everything I've done. Miley Cyrus and Lil Nas X. What else? So,
my scooter sucks and hers is better than mine.
Yeah, so, you know, don't get too comfortable. I'll let you ride it a little bit. I feel like if I get on the back of the air, you're definitely gonna wreck us.
I feel the same way.
No faith! I know, it's so beautiful out here though, guys. Damn, this would have been a perfect day to ride a scooter. Okay. Come back here!
Yeah, that's a dusty little bitch. Rolling off with all the love.
Got a good lightning here.
I wanna shoot. And I know I fight. If I tell you once, I'll tell you twice. I'm real discreet. Like a thief in the night. Look, if I call you babe,
babe for the day.
Or babe for the night. You know my wife, she wanna kill, to fuck all night. I wanna fuck my time.
Who do we think we are?
AD, big rocks.
Without the moon room poking. Fuck, what were we thinking?
Bring 300,000 to the dealer. I did some wrong, but I'm always right. So I know how to shoot, and I know how to fight. I tell you once, I'll tell you twice.
Okay, looking for parking.
I'm real discreet. Like a thief in the night.
I'm rich, but I'm riding alone.
Mom ass weather out here.
Go give me some. Ain't they see all this money?
Where are we at?
We are in Longboat Key.
Longboat Key. Okay. And we are going to
St. Armand's
have some cockies.
St. Armand's is a exclusive.
I smell meat. Where's the meat? Where's the meat coming from? Okay. Yeah, I just wanted to. There you go. Y'all can see it. Daiquiri Raw Bar. Daiquiri Deck Raw Bar. Hold on, I'm about to fall and shit. Here, go get this.
I love watching it. Old white people.
They do. Because we look cool. We over here looking all exotic with the green hair.
Are you look, practice your TikTok skills now. Get your phone out. Me too, I just did the same thing. But anyways, all right, this is where we're going. We're currently, well, we were waiting on CVS because our doctor had called in some emergency prescriptions for me. And we were waiting around for them to fill the prescription. They were acting like they didn't know how long it was gonna take. So literally as soon as we pulled off, to go just, you know, do something else, they text me. So yeah, that's where we're at. Okay, let's find the food menu like ASAP.
Hello.
Okay. I was about to say, is there upstairs?
Yeah.
I can get a better view up there.
Right. Lead the way.
Ooh, these stairs are pretty. Wait, I have to TikTok this. Look, see, sometimes it's blurry, but then like I'll tap it. And then it'll focus in like on whatever I'm doing. So yeah.
That's so nice.
She said I look professional when I'm vlogging.
You do. You look so good.
I don't know what I'm doing.
you look like you know what you're doing.
Right.
You
so all I do is point and shoot. That's it.
The work.
What are you doing, Skip? All right, thank you. Oh yes, this is perfect. This is gonna be a nice TikTok watch. Okay, so
what are you doing? Yeah,
upstairs at the on the Lido deck. Yes, you're getting it. I might need to steal some of your videos though. That's the thing about it. Cause it got me in it. The drinks are here. We got, what we get? Well, he got his old, guess what he got? Just guess. Brown people love brown liquor. Strawberry Hennessy with an extra shot. And I got, it's called the Karen. So fitting. What's in the Karen? Let me see. All right. Obviously we gotta have an extra shot or whatever. Okay. So the Karen, it says pina colada, frozen. Nothing to complain about here. Top with olives, rosé, vodka. Well, the fruits that's beside it, it looks like a coconut, a peach, and a strawberry. So, yeah, it looks. Delicioso. Hey, delicioso. You want to take a shot? Are you going to mix it in your drink? No, nope. I want to take the shot.
This whole thing?
Yep.
But then my daiquiri don't got nothing.
Well, take half of it.
Okay.
Can we do this time? Good job. Do you cross your arms? I need to do this.
Okay, love.
Why does everybody always
knowing that you got to go for it.
So,
I'll be out to this one, we might as well move this.
So they had conch fritters, but they substituted them for shrimp fritters.
Which I've never heard of.
Yeah, these are crab cakes. This is the seafood Alfredo.
Yes.
Which I was craving pasta all last night. What is this?
That goes with my
potato. To the potato. And what is this?
That is a steak.
Oh, that's what you ordered?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
That's a thing, look, guys.
Good, thank you. Yeah.
Thank you. Appreciate it.
Thank you. Alrighty, we done made a mess. So.
What was that? I just lost my train of thought. Okay, upcoming. We've been missing for a while because, you know, maybe you don't know, but very few people do know. We got a lot of stuff going on, like, even at up until this very moment, like, with it's like it never ends. I feel like I slowly but surely coming out of this very deep depression I have gotten myself into. I mean, rightfully so, whether it be all the medications I've been on. Between, you know, like I said, everything going on in our personal life. But, you know, I wasn't gonna upload those videos. I did document a little bit here and there. Our last two FETs. I did document a little bit here and there, like just for, I don't know, documentation purposes. In case I ever wanted to post about it. But I felt at that point in time, I rather kept those things private because
it's
a lot, y'all. And then we have like the world and everybody else and their mama asking you every five minutes what's going on to be updated instead of just, you know, waiting for the updates like everybody else, it becomes a lot. So yeah, I decided against that, but now that I've gotten myself into a better headspace to the point where I was able to deal with my emotions on my own, I will be uploading those and everything soon. But while we're here, as far as our next steps, we have decided to move forward with our third FET. We have decided to move forward with our third FET.
She's the
it doesn't matter what I am. You're here for once, actually here, and I'm not talking to my motherfucking self about my ghost of a boyfriend. Can you please interact with me?
Yeah, okay, I don't know what
we.
I said we instead of I. So y'all four.
We are going on our third. I said we. And just now. No, I suck at this. I don't know what I'm doing. I apologize, America.
Okay, so anyway, it wouldn't be us unless our third transfer happened to be right in the middle of our Jamaica trip. Literally just booked a trip to Jamaica, and literally yesterday just got our calendar for our transfer, and it's going to be a little bit after Valentine's Day if everything goes well. I had to start my medications today, but they were obviously sent to my pharmacy in Atlanta, and I needed them to emergency send them bitches down here until I get back home. And that's why we are here waiting on that. I actually just got a text saying that they're ready all of a sudden. But, and that's another thing.
10 minutes after we left.
This process is so tedious. It's so scientific and technical, down to the day, down to the hour of, you know, the amounts of everything that you need to take. It's not easy. It's not a process to where people just think, oh, shoot some sperm up there, oh, let it touch the egg and everything. It's nothing like that. It's nothing like that at all. Everything is literally scientifically planned out to the hour, revolving around your body, you know, because that's part of all the process of the constant monitoring, the blood monitoring, and the ultrasounds every other day, getting your vagina probed. They're really like on top of everything. And the fact that I was supposed to start this single medication this morning, and I have, it's like what, almost 2-3 o'clock now, and I haven't taken it yet. She's telling me that, oh, don't worry if you miss a day, just take it when you know, as soon as you get it, like, but it doesn't make me feel any better, because when you do this process and you go back and it doesn't work, you're constantly running back in your mind what you did wrong, what you could have done differently. And I literally, like, every step of the way try to do everything perfectly, and I think that's the part that I really couldn't wrap my head around. Around the holidays, my transfer was on the 17th, like 5 days away from Christmas and New Year's. And then a week away from his heart surgery. And then this week's events that just came up with the whole COVID diagnosis. It's just like, it never ends. When does it end? When? For us, when are we gonna get a break? When are we gonna catch a friggin' break? That's all I wanna know.
I don't know, because I was really hoping that 2022 would be different than 2021.
Yeah. I was one of the most optimistic people at the beginning of this process, but 3 IUIs later and 3 transfers, IVF transfers later, nothing, like, you kind of lose the spark. Kind of start losing the hope. You kind of like, well, no, it's no answers. I want somebody to tell me, oh, you can't have kids because your uterus is shaped funny. You can't have kids because you got endometriosis and tumors. You can't have kids because you're this. Like, tell me something's wrong with me, and I would feel 100,000 times better than y'all just keep telling me everything's perfect every single time and then nothing.
We have superior, you know, embryos.
Oh yeah. Superior. Oh, on top of that, I have superior embryos. My lining is amazing.
Amazing.
It's nothing. I just have no answers in this process, and that's the part I think that really, really weighs heavy on me every single time, getting your hopes up when, and it just seems so easy for everybody else. The universe hates me right now. That's how I feel about it. It's crazy. You know, you gotta love whatever you get.
Yeah.
And I know I am, with everything in me, all this stuff I've been through. I am with everything in me, but you know, it's just kind of crushing when you have all the opportunity to have something go exactly your way, and it still doesn't go your way. Like, not many people out there get to choose the sex of their baby that they wanna have. So this is just living proof that everything is not going your way every time you want it. But you gotta roll with the punches, and that's that. That's another thing that we were discussing. Should we do another egg retrieval? Blah, blah, blah. He still has to do his, but once again, his heart surgery is pushed back, which is gonna push back all the rest of the things that we have to get done, and I'm not getting any younger. I do not want to be 40 still going through this. Like, give me a break. Yeah. He's younger than me, so the original plan was for me to use his. I wouldn't even have done the egg retrieval process at all if he was, you know, able to do his part off rips. I wouldn't even put myself through that. I don't care about all the extra DNA, all that other stuff. My kid is my kid. That's not a big deal breaker in my mind about whatever, whose eggs it is. And like I said, I actually would probably prefer it to be his. Being so handsome and so much younger than me.
Not that much younger.
And the perfect.